You wake up, grab your phone, and open your crypto wallet. Your heart stops. It's empty. Every token gone. You frantically check for notifications, for any sign of a breach, but there's nothing. Your seed phrase is locked in a safe right where you left it. Your hardware wallet is sitting on your desk, cold, silent, and untouched. There are no suspicious emails, no alerts, no trace of an attack. It's as if your funds just vanished into thin air while you were sleeping. So, how did they do it? How did thieves drain your wallet without your keys, your password, or any of the things you were told to protect? The scary part is they didn't need any of them. They used an invisible bug, a silent exploit that you authorized weeks, maybe even months ago without ever knowing it. In this video, I'm going to show you exactly how these sophisticated attacks work and the crucial steps you must take to make sure this nightmare never happens to you. This is the threat almost no one is talking about, and it bypasses nearly every standard security measure you have in place. For years, the crypto security mantra has been brutally simple, right? Protect your seed phrase. We've been told over and over to carve it into steel, lock it in a fireproof safe, and never, ever store it digitally. The gospel was, if you control the keys, you control the crypto. If your keys are secure, your funds are secure. But what if I told you that in the world of Web3, that's no longer enough? What if the very design of the decentralized apps we use every day has created a new, silent way to get robbed that makes your seed phrase totally irrelevant? The reality of crypto theft in 2025 has moved way beyond simple phishing emails or a thief finding your 12-word recovery phrase. The game has changed. Today, the smartest hackers aren't trying to break down your front door. They're tricking you into giving them a key you don't even know exists. They're exploiting the very foundation of smart contracts. Let's break this down. When you interact with a decentralized application, a DEX, a lending protocol, an NFT marketplace, your wallet does more than just send and receive funds. To make the dApp work, you have to grant it permissions. You have to sign a message that gives the app's smart contract an allowance to interact with the tokens in your wallet. Here's an analogy. A simple Bitcoin transaction is like handing a cashier $5 for a coffee. You give them the exact amount, they give you the coffee, and the deal is done. Nobody has any further claim on the other's money. But interacting with a dApp on Ethereum is more like giving a bartender your debit card to start a tab. You're not paying for each drink one by one. You're giving them permission to charge your account for whatever you order. You're trusting the bartender not to abuse that permission. And this is exactly where the danger is. That permission you grant is called a token approval. To save you time and gas fees, many dApps ask for unlimited approval. They ask for permission to access all of your USDC or all of your favorite NFTs forever. You sign this once, and the dApp can now move those tokens on your behalf whenever its code tells it to, without you having to sign for every little thing. It's convenient. It's also incredibly dangerous. The bug, the invisible thief, isn't in your wallet. It's in the smart contract you gave that permission to. Hackers aren't just trying to break into your wallet anymore. Instead, they create malicious smart contracts, disguise them as something legitimate, and trick you into granting them unlimited approvals. Once you sign that one transaction, the trap is set. The hackers can wait hours, days, or months. Then, whenever they want, like in the middle of the night, they can call a function in that malicious contract. And because you already gave your permission, the contract will obey their command and drain every single token you approved. You won't get a notification. You won't be asked to confirm on your hardware wallet. The blockchain will just see it as a legitimate action that you authorized. This is what's known as a wallet drainer attack, and it has become an epidemic. In the first half of 2025 alone, billions of dollars have been stolen through hacks, with a huge and growing chunk coming from these wallet-draining attacks that target regular users like you and me. These aren't just big exchange hacks. This is a direct assault on personal wallets. The threat is getting worse with the rise of drainer-as-a-service platforms. Cybercriminal groups now package these malicious scripts into easy-to-use toolkits and sell them on the dark web. This means even low-skilled scammers can launch highly sophisticated attacks. They'll spin up counterfeit websites that perfectly mimic popular dApps, airdrop you worthless tokens to lure you to a malicious site, or use a hacked Twitter account to promote a fake NFT mint. You think you're just claiming an airdrop, but the transaction you're signing isn't for an airdrop at all. It's an unlimited approval, a blank check. What makes this so terrifying is that it preys on a core misunderstanding of what we're signing. Wallet interfaces, even on hardware wallets, often struggle to explain this clearly. They might just show you a long string of code and ask for your signature. This is called blind signing. You're approving an action without fully understanding the consequences. You see a request from what looks like a trusted site, and you click confirm. In that single moment, the heist is 99% complete. The actual theft is just a matter of time. This is the new reality. Your biggest vulnerability isn't the piece of paper your seed phrase is on. It's the trust you place in the smart contracts you interact with every day. The bug isn't a piece of malware that breaks into your house. It's a social engineering trick that convinces you to leave the back door wide open forever. To really get how invisible and devastating these attacks are, let me walk you through a fictional but totally realistic scenario. Let's meet John. John isn't a newbie. He's been in crypto for years. He's read the security guides and he scoffs at people who fall for obvious scams. He's what you'd call a sophisticated user. He's exactly the kind of person who thinks, this could never happen to me. John's security is textbook. His main holdings, Bitcoin, Ethereum, stablecoins, are secured on a top-of-the-line hardware wallet. His seed phrase has never been typed or photographed. He etched it onto a steel plate stored in a bank's safe deposit box. For his daily dApp interactions, he uses a separate hot wallet. But even that is protected with a strong password and two-factor authentication. The man is meticulous. One Tuesday evening, John's browsing Twitter. An account he follows, belonging to a famous digital artist, posts an exciting announcement, a surprise free art drop for their followers. The tweet has thousands of likes. Other legit accounts are replying with excitement. It all looks completely authentic. The link leads to a slick professional website. The URL is a little different from the artist's usual site. It's a .art domain instead of .com, but that's common for special projects. Everything looks right. To claim his free NFT, the site prompts John to connect his wallet. He uses his hot wallet, his designated Degen wallet. A pop-up appears asking him to sign a transaction to claim the asset. John glances at it. It looks like a standard interaction with a smart contract. Since it's a free mint, there's no cost besides the gas fee. He clicks confirm. A success message pops up. He checks his wallet, but the NFT isn't there yet. The site says it could take a few hours to distribute. John thinks nothing of it, disconnects his wallet, closes his browser, and goes to sleep. The next morning, John makes his coffee, sits down at his desk, and opens his portfolio tracker. His stomach drops. His hot wallet, which held several thousand dollars in ETH and other tokens, now shows a balance of zero. Panic. He opens the wallet itself. It's all gone. Every last token. He frantically checks the transaction history. And there they are. At 3:17 a.m., a series of outgoing transactions drained his account. One after another, his tokens were sent to an unknown address. He doesn't recognize them. He sure as hell didn't approve them in the middle of the night. He was asleep. How was this possible? Here's what really happened. The hacker didn't need access to John's computer at 3:17 a.m. The hard part was already over the moment John clicked confirm. The bait. The hacker used social engineering. They either hacked the artist's real Twitter account or created a convincing fake one, leveraging the artist's reputation and everyone's FOMO to drive traffic to their malicious site. The malicious contract, the website John visited, was just a front for a drainer. The smart contract wasn't designed to mint an NFT, it was designed to steal assets. The deceptive signature, when John clicked confirm, he wasn't signing a minting transaction. The pop-up was intentionally vague. He was actually signing a set approval for all or increase allowance function. He gave that malicious contract unlimited permission to move all of his tokens. He essentially handed the thief a signed blank check. The execution. The hacker now had the permission they needed. They didn't act immediately because that might look suspicious. Instead, their automated script waited. Hours later, in the dead of night, the hacker called the transfer from function. This function basically said, hey, remember that permission John gave you? I'm using it now. Transfer all his USDC to my wallet. Because John had pre-approved this, the Ethereum network saw it as a valid transaction. The smart contract was just doing what John had authorized it to do. No new signature was needed. No hardware wallet prompt was required. To the blockchain, it just looked like John was moving his own money. John did everything he was supposed to do. He kept his seed phrase offline. He used a separate wallet. He disconnected from the site. But he fell for the one thing he didn't fully grasp, the power of the approvals he was granting. His story is a chilling example of the modern crypto heist. It's silent, it's invisible, and it exploits trust, not passwords. The thief never broke into John's house. John unknowingly invited him in and told him to take whatever he wanted, whenever he wanted. For years, we've pictured crypto security like a medieval fortress. We build thick walls with a strong password, install a vault with a hardware wallet, and hide the master key, the seed phrase, where no one can find it. But John's story proves that model is dangerously outdated. The threat isn't at the gates anymore. It's already inside, disguised as a friend. So how do we defend against an attack that just sidesteps our main security tools? We need to shift our mindset. It's not just about protecting your assets when they're sitting still. It's about being paranoid about every single interaction your wallet makes. Every signature is a potential risk. Every approval is a ticking time bomb. Your new defense strategy comes down to three main ideas: vigilance, verification, and segregation. This is your new action plan. Pillar one, extreme vigilance, trust nothing. Your first line of defense is psychological. You have to kill your FOMO and adopt a healthy dose of paranoia, especially when something seems too good to be true. Scrutinize every link. Treat every link for a free mint or airdrop as a potential trap. Hackers create pixel-perfect clones of real sites. Always double-check URLs for subtle misspellings. Don't trust a link just because it came from a verified account. Those accounts get hacked all the time. Beware of urgency. Be extremely wary of anything that creates a sense of urgency. Countdown timers, limited supply warnings. These are classic tricks to make you act fast and think later. They want you to rush through the approval without reading it. Ask why. Before signing anything, ask, why does this dApp need this permission? If you're swapping 100 USDC, does the contract really need permission to access all 1 million USDC in your wallet forever? The answer is no. Legitimate dApps should let you set specific spending caps. If they demand unlimited access with no other option, that's a huge red flag. Pillar 2, active verification. The trust but verify toolkit. Vigilance isn't enough. You need tools to see what's really happening and to audit the permissions you've already given out. Use a transaction simulator. This is probably the single most important tool you can add to your setup. Services like Pocket Universe or Wallet Guard act as a firewall for your wallet. They're browser extensions that pop up before your wallet does, showing you in plain English what a transaction will actually do. It will say, "This will give contract Y unlimited permission to spend your USDC." If you see a warning like that, you reject the transaction. There's no longer any excuse for blind signing. Perform regular approval audits. The silent drainer relies on permissions you granted months ago. Disconnecting your wallet from a site does not revoke the approval. It lives on the blockchain forever until you cancel it. You have to periodically review and revoke these old allowances. How? Use a trusted token approval checker. Etherscan has one, and another popular tool is revoke.cash. The process. Connect your wallet and the site will show you every contract that has permission to move your tokens. You will probably be shocked by how long the list is. The purge. Go through this list and be ruthless. Don't recognize a contract. Revoke its permission. Don't use a service anymore. Revoke it. See an unlimited approval? Revoke it. Yes, revoking costs a small gas fee, but it's a tiny price to pay for peace of mind. Think of it as changing the locks on your house. You should do this at least once a month. Pillar 3, segregation. Limit the blast radius. Even with the best habits, a mistake can happen. Your final layer of defense is to make sure that if one part of your system gets hit, the damage is contained. The burner wallet is your best friend. Never ever interact with a new or unproven dApp using your main wallet. That's financial suicide. Set up a burner wallet, a completely separate wallet with its own seed phrase for these risky plays. How to use it? Want to try a new mint? Send only the exact amount of crypto needed for that one transaction to your burner wallet. Then, connect only the burner to the new site. If it turns out to be a drainer, the most you can lose is the small amount in that wallet. Your main stash is safe. Tier your wallets. Get organized like a pro. Tier 1, the vault, cold storage. This is for your long-term holds. It should be a hardware wallet that never interacts with dApps. Its only job is to receive funds for safekeeping. Tier 2, the savings wallet, hardware wallet. This can also be a hardware wallet, but it's the one you use for trusted blue chip dApps you've known for years, like Uniswap or Ava. You still practice strict approval hygiene here. Tier 3, the checking account, hot wallet, burner. This is your browser wallet with a small amount of cash. You use it for new dApps and speculative mints, and you should assume it could be compromised at any time. By adopting this three-part strategy, you're no longer just sitting in a fortress hoping no one gets in. You become an active security agent, inspecting everything at the gate and ensuring that even if an enemy gets past, they're trapped in one unimportant room. This is how you survive in Web3. If this is making you rethink your entire crypto security setup, good. It should. To help you put all this into practice, I've put together a checklist and a list of the verification tools I mentioned, like revoke.cash and Wallet Guard, over on my website. The link is in the description. It's a free resource to help you audit your wallet step by step. And while you're down there, if you're getting value from this video, please hit that subscribe button. The threats are always changing, and my job is to keep you ahead of them. Your subscription helps the channel grow and make sure you don't miss the next security briefing. Okay, so you've adopted the new mindset. You're now safer than 95% of crypto users. But for those who want Fort Knox level security, there are a few more advanced layers we can add. One, harden your digital environment. So far, we've focused on smart contract risk, but what if the threat is on your actual computer? Clipboard hijackers. This is a simple but terrifying piece of malware. It runs silently in the background, monitoring your clipboard. When it sees you copy a crypto address, it instantly swaps it with the hacker's address. You think you're sending funds to your own vault, you paste the address, the first and last few characters look right, so you hit send, and the money is gone. Defense: never trust your clipboard for a big transaction. After pasting an address, check every single character. Better yet, use address whitelisting features in your wallet or exchange. When sending to a hardware wallet, display the QR code on the device itself and scan it with your phone, avoiding the clipboard completely. Malicious browser extensions. Browser extensions can read and change anything you see in your browser. A malicious one can fake a MetaMask pop-up to steal your password or trick you into signing a bad transaction. Defense: be ruthless with your extensions. Go to your extension list right now and remove everything you don't absolutely need and trust. For your crypto activity, consider using a totally separate browser that has only your wallet extension and a transaction simulator installed, nothing else. Second, explore next generation wallets. Wallet technology is evolving to fight these threats. Multi-signature, multi-sig wallets. A multi-sig wallet is like a bank vault that needs two different keys to open. You can set up a 2-of-3 multi-sig, for example. It has three keys, and any transaction requires signatures from at least two of them. How it protects you. Even if you get tricked into approving a malicious contract with one key, the attacker can't drain your funds. They'd need the second signature from a key they don't have. You can keep one key on your hardware wallet, one on a backup device in another location, and one on your phone. This makes theft exponentially harder. For anyone with serious holdings, looking into solutions like Safe is a necessity. Smart contract wallets and account abstraction, this is the future. Instead of just a key, your wallet becomes a programmable smart contract itself. This lets you build your own security rules. Potential features. Imagine setting a daily withdrawal limit, or whitelisting addresses so your wallet can only send funds to people you trust, or even setting up social recovery, where trusted friends can help you regain access if you lose your device without ever being able to touch your funds themselves. This tech is still emerging, but will be a game changer. Third, physical and real world security. Finally, don't forget the real world. The $5 wrench attack, where a thief uses violence to force you to give up your keys, is a real and scary threat. The gray man strategy. Your best defense is obscurity. Don't brag about your crypto wealth on social media. Don't make yourself a target. Plausible deniability. This is where your tiered wallet system can save you. If an attacker forces you to drain your wallet, you open your tier 3 burner wallet with a few hundred dollars in it. For a more serious attacker, you might give them access to your tier 2 wallet, which has a meaningful but not life-destroying amount of crypto. Your main vault, the keys to which are not nearby, remains a secret. By layering these defenses, you build a system that's resilient. Even if one layer fails, the others can protect you. We've been through a lot, and the threats are genuinely frightening. The thought of a thief draining your life savings while you sleep, using a permission you gave them months ago, is a nightmare. It proves that the old advice, just protect your seed phrase, isn't enough anymore. The game has changed. Hackers aren't breaking down the door. They're tricking you into handing them the key. But the point of this isn't to scare you away from crypto. It's to empower you. Fear comes from the unknown. Power comes from understanding. And now you understand the threat. You know the biggest risk isn't some complex cryptographic flaw. It's a moment of unchecked trust, a rushed signature on something that seemed too good to be true. You now have the framework to defend yourself. Your new mantra is vigilance, verification, and segregation. Be vigilant. Question everything. Be a verifier. Use simulators before you sign, and use revokers to clean up the past. Be segregated. Use burner wallets for risky moves and keep your main stash locked down. This is what being your own bank really means. It's not just about holding your keys. It's about being your own chief security officer. It takes discipline and a healthy dose of paranoia. The convenience of an unlimited approval is not worth the risk of financial ruin. The small gas fee to revoke an approval is the best investment you'll ever make. This new financial world is a wild frontier, and it's full of traps. But with the right knowledge and tools, you can navigate it safely. The power to protect your assets is in your hands. Don't give it away with a single careless click. Stay safe, stay skeptical, and stay secure.